And this is your first challenge, because there is not a reference to that. We have the reference of Estonia, about digital identity, in all related to the awareness, in all related to the relationship of the identity with the government and with the private sector, that it's a reference for us, but it's a digital identity match by the government. From the other side, it's we have the maturity of the technology, mm-hmm. and then we are defining a governance that it's not directly strictly connected to a specific technology. This is relevant because the technology itself can help, but the governance that we have and the relationship that the citizen has with the identity needs to be needs to have a future roadmap and can be connected to different technologies. And this is also a challenge. And for us, this is innovation. This is a new approach. For sure, when we launch an identity like that, we will have also some process to arrive to specific groups and to deal with some specific services of the government. Not starting, we will have access to all with that, because we need also to arrive at a mature environment for also for the scale of the project. But right now we have one of the biggest stoppers and the biggest challenge is that we have a decree law for the Spanish government, mm-hmm. I'm sure that you know about that, that don't allow any public institution to promote or develop this kind of technology. And only if there is an authorization, I don't know the name of an organization that it's a state that provides the conflict relationship between the peers. But blockchain is the opposite to that.
Yeah.
you want to cut this intermediate institution that provides the authorization of the authority. Central
state,
authority, no?
State General Administration, AGE in Spanish, AGE.
Yeah. If you have a central authority that you need, that it's not distributed model. And this is right now a big stop to that, because also it's closing the possibility of private sector to develop this kind of technology. It's not only for the public institutions. Mm-hmm. And not for Catalonia, it's for the whole state. There are a lot of other autonomous communities and cities or public administrations that what will happen right now with some of the blockchain projects that we have been doing. It's focused on identity, but you know that the powerful of the blockchain technology arrives when you really incorporate identity.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can have traceability, you can test, but if you want to engage the citizen, you have to put the identity. You can put a digital identity and not necessarily self-sovereign identity, but it's strange that you are promoting models of decentralized environment and the core of this model is not a decentralized identity. We will fight against that. We have the commitment of this is not because the position is not related for really the technology from the Spanish government. It's related to a specific situation in mm-hmm. Catalonia, and this needs to be solved in another way. The technology, the innovation, is not really the problem, because the technology will arrive. If they stop or not, you cannot put the doors to the field that it's safe. And we have, because from a legal situation, it's they changed 7 laws with this decree.
Yeah.
And also it's inconstitutional, it's not related to European frameworks. Europe defines the eIDAS, that it's electronic identification. It's not blockchain specifically, it's more generic, but allows institutions like the government and others to develop this kind of identity. And then it is not really related to the legal framework and the European framework, because the decree says that if Europe will regulate that, or Spain will regulate that, then it could be done. But the European Parliament and the European Commission says that because they provide the governance for the models, not for the technology. We are always agnostic in technology, the government and the European Union. And Spain has done the opposite, that they want to stop a specific technology and they put distributed ledger technologies. And the problem is the one that I was starting to talk about, because it has been a technology used by the civic movements in the Catalan process. But we have a common front from the different autonomous communities, maybe not all, because of from all the parties, but the one, any of the autonomous community are not aligned to this decree. And also with the European support, it has been talked in the European Parliament. Mm-hmm. There are also some lobby work there in the European institutions to define really that, well, to press political press pressure from different sides to the Spanish government to change this decree law. And also we need the help of the blockchain communities, because this stops the innovation. This will stop the investments in Catalonia, the economic growth, and the creation of new jobs. And the Spanish government is blocking a new economy in Spain. At least we are in Spain right now. And because what you need if you are a startup, if you are an entrepreneur, it's a framework that helps to your objectives. Otherwise, there are a lot of places to develop, and it's for us, it's one of the, I think that the biggest challenge that we already have for this Identicat, that it's the name that we put to the digital identity. We are not very good with the Catalan name of our project. We always put cat at the end.
It's
my cat.
It's a star.
Yeah. People also.